ప్రపన్న పారిజాతాయ తోత్ర వేత్రైకపాణయే జ్ఞానముద్రాయ కృష్ణాయ గీతామృతదుఖే నమః. ఓం నమో వెంకటేశాయ. మై పరిపూర్ణ ఆశీర్వాదంస్ అండ్ బెస్ట్ విషెస్ టు ఆల్ ద వ్యూవర్స్ ఆఫ్ శ్రీ వెంకటేశ్వర భక్తి ఛానల్. హరిహి ఓం. శ్రీమద్ భగవద్గీత సెకండ్ చాప్టర్ వర్స్ నంబర్ 14. శ్రీ భగవాన్ ఉవాచ మాత్రా స్పర్శాస్తు కౌంతేయ శీతోష్ణ సుఖ దుఃఖదాః ఆగమాపాయినో నిత్యాః తాం స్థితిక్షస్వ భారత. As we learnt, there are two realities which are experienced by us. In the beginning itself, when we began the second chapter, at that time itself I introduced. What are those two realities? And both of them are in the form of experience. With all the individuals, you also experience that two kinds of reality. The thing is, we have not yet noticed, because we identify ourselves with one reality, we ignore another reality, and that reality is the very much important reality. Somehow we are ignorant to that reality. Now Bhagavan Krishna introduced that ignored reality to Arjuna. That's what he spoke, he explained in the verse number 12. That reality is known as eternal reality. That reality is called Atma, which is in the form of consciousness. In Sanskrit we say Chaitanyam. And one more reality is known as Anatma. From verse number 13, Bhagavan Krishna is explaining to Arjuna what the reality means, what the nature of this Anatma is. First, we learnt the nature of Anatma is Vikaravan or Vikaravat. That which undergoes modifications, changes. Whether we like or not, they keep changing. One student came after a lecture, when I was sitting after a lecture in an university. He asked that in husky voice, Swamiji, yes, is there any way or mantra to change my nose? I asked, why? You know, Swamiji, I don't like my nose. I said, since when you don't like? From the childhood. Is there any particular reason? Is it criticized? He said, no Swamiji, actually no, I am not like the person whom I want to be, who I want to be. This student, he seems to be okay, he was matured enough, he had a few questions during the lecture, it was quite okay. But personally he is living with that self-conclusion with not accepting his nose. He could accept everything. Then I said, could you accept other parts of your body? Yes, yes, of course Swamiji, if the nose is perfect, then I will be perfect. Then I told, why can't you go for plastic surgery? He said, Swamiji, you know, I am still a student, so I need to have lots of money for that. I don't want to disturb father. So my father, may he have money, but that all money is earned by him. Therefore, I don't want to. And that too is a huge process, Swamiji. Somehow I gave the clarity. So many of us, we are not able to accept what we are. Always we want to become somebody. That becoming somebody is not or won't help to solve the problem which we have. Because when you want to become somebody, it means you are not satisfied with what the body you are. That's the miserable. When you have the device, this device which comes throughout your life, you need to interact properly with this device. Otherwise, what will happen? You live in a, in a mentality, that mentality which is not a satisfied one, that will impact or affect all your outcomings. You cannot give 100% yourself to any job, to any relations. It means what? You miss to live your life completely. Therefore, first of all, we should realize the nature of this anatma. Just I am using the word, anatma. Anatma means that is the second reality. The first reality is known as atma, that which is in the form of I, which is experienced day and night by me and you. This anatma also is a kind of reality which is experienced by us, that also in the form of I or mine. Now the nature of this anatma to be realized. Now for example, because it's the main tool for our life. And Bhagavan Krishna, he goes to the point where all the problems begin. He touches it. Therefore, he is explaining the nature of anatma. It means nature of our body. Not only the nature of our body, because our body is connected with the prakriti, means world. This worldly object, they are connected with our body. In these words, he says, matraha, means this body contains sense organs, eyes, nose, tongue, and touching sense, and ears. These five sense organs are the main tool you to connect with the world, isn't it? Is there any other organ that you can connect with the world? No, only five sensory organs. And you may say that I have mind and buddhi, I can connect with the people with that. No. The data which are provided by this sense organ alone, you are using in your mind level, in your buddhi level. Therefore, our total life is dependent on this five sense organ. Do you know that? These five sensory organs, you think they are with you, they belong to you, but reality, the truth is something else. You imagine a situation. You think of the world which is soundless. I said to imagine. When there is no sound, can you hear something? Of course not. Okay, when you don't hear something, can you experience the sense organ of hearing? Now, when there is a sound, it's a sound. When there is a sound, at that time alone, we experience our hearing capacity, which we call it Shrotrendriya. Swamiji, these are all basic teaching, you know. No, we have to begin from here. We think that we are endowed with a hearing capacity. I do have the hearing capacity. That hearing capacity is belonging to me. I own it. But that's not. Because where there is no sound, your hearing capacity won't be experienced by you. It means what? It won't be there or not, you cannot confirm. Therefore, this hearing capacity, is it connected with you or with sound? The sense organs are connected with sensory objects. Ears are connected with sound. Eyes are connected with the form and colors, light or dark. Nose are connected with the smells. Tongue is connected with the taste. And these, all the sense organs, we think they belong to us. Because of our potentiality, I am able to connect with that. No. If there is no sound, you cannot experience ears, means a hearing capacity. If there are no forms, nama rupas. If these rupas means color and forms, you cannot see anything, you cannot experience your seeing capacity. If there are no tastes, you cannot experience your tasting capacity. It means they are connected with outside sources. Whether you like or not, your ears are open. They are kept open. They are always connected. This hearing capacity doesn't get your permission when there is a sound taking place. Just it provides the data that you are who is getting connected with the ear. Sometimes you may not get connected with the ears. When you will be watching, observing a movie, when you are focused to read something, if somebody is calling you, you may not hear that. Now the reality of the sense organs, on which I have completely depended upon to collect the data, and not only that, to communicate to the world, I use the same sense organs. Now, that main organs are limited. That's what Krishna says. Just you should understand, these organs can collect the data according to your karma phala alone. If your karma phala permits, these sense organs will see more effulgently. Therefore, we have to have a clarity. What I know about the world is not the complete knowledge. What I have, what I want, the clarity of the world, they cannot be, they need not be 100%. And also, Krishna goes one step further. These sense organs, they don't do a duty of only mere to provide the data, they also bring emotions. They also brings emotions. For example, somebody has provided, gifted you a mobile. A beautiful mobile. Because mobile versions are updated week by week. I should say day by day. You know, this anatma, it needs to be updated. You should keep updating, otherwise your grandson or granddaughter will criticize you. You are out of update. Therefore, somebody has given a mobile as a gift. Whenever you look at the mobile, you get happiness. You remember him and you remember the experience which we had with that particular person. You get connected with that experience through this object. You become happy. You become now and then satisfied. Whenever you see that material, that object, gifted object, after a few weeks or month, you got a fight with that particular person. Now, when you look at this object, the object will make you sad or to provoke your anger. You become irritated to that mobile. You throw the mobile and you go and you pick again. Now, can you file a kind of FIR on the mobile? Sir, this mobile is giving, sometimes it gives happiness, sometimes it gives a kind of irritating condition. We are not that much, you know, ignorant people, but we become often. See, these indriyas are connected with the world, certain sounds. You know, if a lovable people, if they scolded us, you know, out of love, they say, you are an idiot, you know, you don't get angry. If the same word, if you hear from somebody whom you don't like, then your reactions are different. It means the nature of the sense organs, the nature of this outside world, it affects you. Can we blame our sense organs? No, we cannot. The sound has got its own quality. Taste has got its own quality. Indriyas, they have their own capacity. The connection of both, you know, the connection of both gives experiences. Those experiences, not because of the nature of sensory organs, not because of the nature of the sensory objects. Those because of my karma phala. When we will have this understanding, then what? This situation means you can interact with this body and the world positively. You won't smash that object, you won't collapse you don't condemn your device. When you don't accept, you are not able to accept your nose. If at all you undergo a plastic surgery, you got cleared with the nose, but the problem won't solve. Therefore, we should make effort to get away from the problem, not through this reacting, the way in which you react with the object, to interact with the object. You should have a different understanding. First, you should realize the nature. He says, Matraha Sparishastu Kaunteya Shita Ushna Sukha Dukkha Daha. Matraha. Ma means to measure, tra means the instruments. These sense organs are the instrument through which you can measure, means experience these opposites. Shita, Ushna. So when you are in a summer, you experience that hot weather as well as in the winter cold weather. So when summer comes, you will have the experience of hot weather. It may cause dukkha to you. It may disturb you. When winter comes, again, you know, you suffer. But you cannot blame winter, you cannot blame summer. You cannot blame your body too. That is self-acceptance. Because a fruit or a dish, a sweet, it's like, you know, you cannot also say that it's good or bad. Good things sometimes you may get irritated with. For example, you know, I can give a proper example. Take a sugar, white sugar. White sugar, you know, so many people are fond of sugar and they are crazy about it. When you make some sweet out of sugar, when you eat, you feel very happy because your sensory organs are providing data. You become very happy. But you know, this white sugar, it has got the nature, the real nature taste of white sugar is sour, not sweetness. This sour, see, there's a tamarind as sour in taste, but this sugar has a different taste. It appears, it looks like as though it is very sweet in a taste, but the real nature of the sugar is sour. So when you take, you know, this much amount of tamarind, your digestive system is collapsed. Too much tamarind, it collapses the digestive system. At the same way, when you take white sugar, it's the awareness I got from an Ayurvedic doctor. The white sugar, it has a sour in nature, it will do what tamarind does. But you were happy. And we have one more object. That one more object, take a bitter gourd and have a curry with bitter gourd. When you eat, so some people like curry, okay, bitter gourd. But when you don't like it, because it's not in the taste, it gives bitter taste, but that is good for your health. Your experience gives your data a kind of happiness and sadness. They are false. Don't depend on these data. You have to be very clear. Whether it is sweet or bitter, you should have a clarity which gives a healthy body. That's what, you know, we are victimized by the sense organs. Krishna says, don't become a victim to that. Just endure them. Titikshasva Bharata. That endurance must be developed with the system, with the nature. He says, Matra sparishastu kaunteya shitoshna sukha dukkhadaha. The sense organs and sensory objects, they have their own connection. Those connections will give sometimes happiness, sometimes sorrow, sometimes irritative nature. Be with endurance. That's all. Because they are not eternal. They are agama apayinaha. The same object will may give sorrow. The same object may give happiness too, like the mobile which I introduced. That's what he says. Hey Kaunteya, hey ho son of Kunti, please try to understand the experiences which comes out of this connection of both Indriyas and Vishayas. They are Anityaha. They are not eternal. Because as I told you already, one karma can give one fruit. Whether it is Punya or Papa, it will give one time. So once it is given or it has given the fruit, that's all, it's completed. Then the object, same object will give a different fruit. Therefore what? If at all you want to work, you have to work with Papa and Punya with the help of Vedic mantras. Otherwise, you need not. This is how we have to interact with our body. This body is a tool for us to live. And this world also is a tool which makes experience with the collaboration with the body. Now, I am the person who should know the reality of this changing reality called Anatma. This Anatma which deludes me. I should not be victimized through this Anatma. This, what I told today, is you have to keep thinking, realize, and you can apply in day to day. When you hear something, and even meditations are taught like that. When you hear something, you should realize, understood what these connections, they are already having connections. That I'm not listening means because of my capacity. They are connected already. Meant for the experience which is in the form of result of my karma. So this clarity will help us to go ahead with, we'll go to next words. Yam hi navyathayantyete purusham purusharshabha samadukha sukham dhiram so amratatvaya kalpate. He goes one step further more, that we will see in the forthcoming episode tomorrow. Harihi Om. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Harihi Om. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.